Welcome to another edition of Coffee with the Goose. You know, we talk about things that are interesting, fascinating, and irritating. I am the Goose. So glad you joined me again. You know, we cover a lot of different topics on this show. A lot of boxing, of course, because we're Pacquiao fans. But, you know, we try and cover other topics. A little politics, a little religion, the two subjects we never talk about, right? A host of other things. But right now we're going to talk about a serious subject, and it's your chance to help some people out, okay? First, we'll start, like we always do, with a sip of some hot, steaming coffee. My coffee, as you know, very strong, like my opinion, and got some creamer in there to make it sweet, just like me. All right. A volcano eruption in the Philippines recently. You know, when things go wrong, when tragedies strike, when we get bad news, and I know all about this personally, you learn to, like you've been taught, to help one another. And you also count your blessings. You realize how blessed you really are. You know, our good friends in the Philippines, where my wife is from, of course, know all about bad news, adversity, and natural disasters. You know, we had that horrific cyclone three, 4 years ago that pretty much leveled one island. And we came to the rescue. I say we, you know, we all did our part with prayers and aid. It's a beautiful thing when you see people eager to help out when things go wrong with you personally. And it feels good to help out when you're on the other end and you see people you love and care for in dire need. It's good to jump up and do what you can. Just had a volcano eruption in the Philippines. It was on the island of Luzon, about 100 miles or 100 kilometers south of Manila. Now, it was a small volcano, but volcanoes are volcanoes. I mean, if you've seen footage of this, didn't look small to me. It looked absolutely frightening. Fortunately, there are no deaths or serious injuries, at least not that you would expect from any volcano. But the damage is done, and there are fears of more damage. Now, tens of thousands of people have been forced from their homes. And when you look at the damage that volcanoes can cause, if you're not in that type of environment, let's put it to you this way. Flooding is a great example. What kind of damage can flooding cause? Well, the flood, the water itself, wrecking your home and business and places of worship. But sometimes the worst damage is when the waters recede. It's a horrible, sticky, disgusting, disease-ridden mess. And if you haven't experienced a flood, serious flood, and I hope you don't, but if you have, you know exactly what I'm talking about. It's very humbling, and again, a great chance for you to reach out and help one another through tough times. We're talking with Roberto from Children's Shelter of Cebu. Mabuhay, Roberto, tell us about your organization.
Absolutely. So the Children's Shelter of Cebu is a shelter, an orphanage for 80 to 100 neglected, abandoned, abused kids in Cebu City, Philippines. And so Cebu is, as you probably know, a large city in the Visayas region, and we've been there for 40 years now doing this.
And when people sponsor your organization, do they sponsor each child individually or as a group?
They can do either or. So we do have sheets here where folks can sponsor a specific child, and their sponsorship then will go towards the daily cost of taking care of the kids, from the house parents to the cooks and just everything that's required to provide them everything that they need. What we try to do at the shelter, again, is really give them a holistic care. So their medical staff, their drivers, really trying to take care of the kids as best we can, sharing with them the love of Christ.
I'm sure many of our viewers are interested in helping your organization out. How much money does it cost to take part in this?
Oh, well, folks can really give any amount that they wish. From the smallest to the largest one-time gift to regular monthly giving. So the children here can be sponsored on a monthly basis if people wish. And yeah, really anything from the smallest amount to the largest. When folks visit the shelter and they see everything that's going on there, we always try to remind them that, you know, all of this was donated by people. From the smallest little Lego piece to the very beautiful homes that the kids can live in, all of it comes from the generosity of folks that sponsor the kids and sponsor the shelter.
And how can we get a hold of you and learn more about your organization?
Yeah, absolutely. You can visit our website, cebushelter.org. It's probably the best way to find all the info. And if you want to know more about me, I've got a little sheet here as well.
Roberto, God bless you. You're making a huge difference. Thank you so much for joining us.
Oh, thank you.
The volcano that erupted in the Philippines recently, as I said, left tens of thousands of people without, at least made them flee their homes. But it left an awful mess with the ash. And of course, with volcanoes, you can also have damage from mud flow, lava, landslides, gases, debris, the explosion. I mean, this is just a whole host of problems that can come as a result of a hurricane erupting. In this area, it was a tourist area around a particular lake. And really scary because in the middle of the lake on one of the islands, about 6,000 people were living and they had to skedaddle. They people rescued them and got them out of there with no physical injuries and no deaths, as I said. But, you know, it's bad enough when your homes, you know, you can't live, you have to clean it up. And your water that you drink is, you can't drink that anymore. Your crops, your livestock, it's unthinkable. But again, could be worse. The area, as I said, is a tourist area. It drew a lot of tourists, hotels, malls, restaurants. It located on a road along a ridge overlooking that lake. And of course, there's a lot of damage that has taken place. And you know, with the volcanoes, it's a lot like earthquakes. You fear the aftershocks, and with volcano, you know, you fear even more damage and more of an explosion is coming. Let's pray that that does not happen. Help is on its way. Manny Pacquiao has donated a lot of money already, and you know, that's what he's all about. He helps those in need, and he is calling on you and me to help out as well. He has promised to match any donation we make for relief efforts in Luzon as a result of that volcano. So way to go, Manny Pacquiao. So now we have to step up and answer the call. How do we do it? Well, of course, you know, if you're nearby, food, blankets, etc., medicine. But the easiest way to do it, the most efficient way to do it, is money. That way the agencies that are receiving your aid will be able to allocate the money in ways that are more efficient and more helpful to those who need the help. And what's the most efficient, cost-effective organization out there for relief? Is Red Cross, of course. It's a worldwide organization. And if you want to help out those in the Philippines, the Philippines Red Cross is the way to do it. Get a pen out. I'll give you that email address and you can help out. And like I said, Manny Pacquiao has promised to match all donations. It is redcross.org.ph. Okay? Donate money to the Red Cross and the Pac-Man will match it for volcano relief in the Philippines. Again, the email address, the web address is redcross.org.ph. And for our brothers and sisters struggling in the Philippines, our prayers, our thoughts are with you. We'll do our best to help you out, okay? That's it for this edition of Coffee with the Goose. Thank you so much for joining us. And got more to come. Stick with me. Talk to you again soon.